Honey, that sweet viscous substance that tastes so good. This delicious goodness is produced efficiently by an intelligent and industrious insect, the honeybee. A lot of work goes into the production of honey by these bees. Honeybees obtain their nutritional requirements from two kinds of food: pollen, a source of protein and nectar, carbohydrates, and water. It is this sugary liquid collected from flowers called nectar that bees use to make honey. But how do honeybees make honey from nectar? Stick around to find out. It all begins in a field of flowers. Worker honeybees suck nectar using their long tubular-shaped tongue. They fly from flower to flower, sucking nectar into their honey stomach for storage. A single bee might have to suck from 1,000 flowers to fill its honey stomach. The honeybee is an extremely strong insect that can fly with nectar or pollen that weighs as much as the bee itself. Once the nectar gets inside the honey stomach, a liquid inside the stomach called enzymes begin to work to produce the honey from nectar. But this process gets weird. When the honey stomach is full, the bee journeys back to the hive. There, it vomits the nectar into one of the indoor bee's mouth. The indoor bee then vomits it into another bee's mouth. This process is continued for about 20 minutes till it reaches storage quality. During this process, moisture is removed from the nectar through evaporation. Though this might seem gross, it is an important part of the honey-making process as more enzymes are added to the nectar. These enzymes convert the nectar into a mixture of fructose and glucose. After the process is complete, the mixture is deposited in the honeycomb that is left unsealed as it is still watery. To reduce the moisture content, the bees beat their wings to create air currents to evaporate water from the honey till it contains about 18% moisture content. The honey is then capped with bee wax secreted from their abdomen. Honey's low moisture content, coupled with its acidic pH, makes it difficult for bacteria and yeast to grow, giving it very long shelf life. Throughout its lifetime, an average worker bee produces 1/12 teaspoon of honey. This means that 12 bees have to work together all their lives to produce 1 teaspoon of honey. To produce 1 pound of honey, bees fly more than once around the world and visit about 12 million flowers. The honey-making process is a labor-intensive one that requires teamwork and coordination. But why do bees go through so much trouble to make honey? They do so to feed their babies and store up for the winter, when food is scarce. So, is it not mean for us to take honey from a beehive? Bees on bee farms produce more honey than they need. The beekeepers only remove the surplus honey and leave behind enough to sustain the hive. Did you enjoy this video? If so, give this video a like and leave us a comment in the comment section. And if you are yet to subscribe, do hit the subscribe button for more interesting animal content like this.